Come on, Karen. Don't act all hurt. It's too late. Where were you when I broke my leg when I was 13? Not with me. When Daniel got a bad flu a couple years ago, you didn't sleep next to him every night. Where were you? Where were you?
You want answers?
Fair enough. So let's talk, because we do have to get your brother out of a cult.
I'm listening.
Mm-hmm. They're a cult.
How did you two survive alone on the road for that long?
It's a long story. I thought I was asking the questions. We almost didn't.
We almost didn't. We just kept moving.
And nobody helped you along the way?
You know I don't have to answer your questions, right?
Some help.
You're right. So tell me what you want from me, Sean.
Nothing, Karen.
Answers.
I mean, what do you want from me?
Yeah, I want answers.
A fucking hug?
Hey, I just want you to know what I did. And why. If you care.
Please tell us.
So, ask me anything.
Okay. Why did you leave?
Alright. Why did you bail on us?
I wasn't meant to be a wife or a mother. I thought I was supposed to. I tried to pretend for many years. But I wasn't happy. And the urge to leave just became unbearable. I had no other choice.
Really?
Are you serious? You chose this life. You fell in love. You made your own choices, right?
Making your own choices doesn't mean you can never fool yourself, Sean. After I had Daniel, you were about 8, and Esteban's garage was getting busy. There was so much going on around me, yet somehow I just felt that my own life was just slipping away. Felt like an empty shell. Sean, it was the hardest decision I ever made. I knew I might never see you all again, but I took that responsibility.
Taking responsibility doesn't mean anything in this case. Dad knew?
Did Dad know about all of this?
I was honest with your father. We did family therapy, but it wasn't about him. It was me.
He was heartbroken.
He was heartbroken for months after you left. Years.
I was too. I was in love with your father. He was the best person I ever met.
But just not enough for you.
Something was missing from the equation, yeah. I was.
Did you just wanderlust? What are you doing here?
So what exactly are you doing in Nevada? You live around here?
No. I'm way out in Arizona. Sean, I told you. Your friend Jacob wrote my P.O. box and said Daniel was in trouble. That's it.
Arizona?
Arizona? Holy shit. It's just lizards and rocks.
Guess I found something there.
There's houses there too, you know.
New York didn't really do me good, so.
Yeah, okay. Think I've heard enough.
I didn't have a choice, Sean. We only have one life. And I didn't want mine to be spent in regrets. For years, I fooled myself. Thinking I'd find satisfaction into what society expected me to be, and that was my mistake. I hope someday you can understand that. But I never stopped caring about you. For what it's worth, I am sorry for hurting you and Daniel and Esteban.
And her parents, too. It's like she left her parents, too. Her parents are just upset that she did that. I know. I'd rather say nothing at this point. I wait, let me say nothing. He's not sorry. He knows she's sorry. I don't like any of these, really. Too late.
Oh, please. It's too fucking late for that shit. No matter what, You left your own kids and my dad.
Yep.
So don't even.
I know it's too late. I want you to know how I feel.
Yeah. I still don't care.
That's three lives versus one, her own. The needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few. Yeah, it is her life, but... And then she upset her parents, too. From the way his grandparents were talking, she left them as well. And they never got over it. I wonder who else she hurt. Very selfish.
Sean, whatever you want to say to me, this is the time. Let's just get it all out in the open. See what happens.
I want to chop your head off with an axe. No. What did you do?
So... What did you do when you left? Where did you go?
I pursued some dreams and failed.
Like what?
Learned the lessons.
Details.
I guess all this time I tried to find out what really matters to me.
Which doesn't involve a husband and two kids.
It does to a lot of people. And I totally respect that. Just not to me.
Hmm.
I wasn't good at making plans. Which is what most of modern life is about, right? School, job, marriage. Ask my mom and dad. They wanted me to follow their rules, their faith. Oh, and I tried, but I wanted to find my own way, with no security blanket. Family, religion, social norms. It's just all about security, after all. But it all just looked like a sweet golden jail to me. I tried to escape that.
Hmm. Was it worth it?
Yeah. Hope it was worth it.
It was. For now, I've found my place in the world. With like-minded people.
Who are they?
I'm at peace with my fuck-ups and my decisions.
Peace?
How do you make peace with bailing on your parents? Your husband and your kids.
I know, that's hard to understand. But I think people should know who they are. And not fake it for anybody.
Why ghost us?
I mean, I get you wanted to leave and stuff. Okay, but why would you ghost us like that?
Why not keep in touch?
Not even a fucking birthday card.
Yeah, that's what's worse. Even.
I thought if I vanished, you would all move on. But I wanted to contact you guys so many times. I almost did.
You wanted a clean break. None of these. I don't want either of these. Either. Because saying this means he understands what she did. That's their mother. You can't just make a clean break as a mother. It's not like, you know, you're in a relationship and you just decide to break up. It's your kids, you know, there's always that connection. good thing you didn't write. See, I don't agree with that either. So I'd be like, well, you should have wrote. So my response would be, well, you should have wrote. You should have sent birthday cards. You should have... something. You know? Just to know that they have a mother who cares. Even though they don't see her for years and years. That's the problem. I don't want either of these. Which one bothers me more, so I cannot choose it. You wanted a clean break. Good thing you didn't. I don't like either of these answers. This is the first time I didn't like any of the answers. Second time already in the last few minutes. Um, Good thing you didn't contact us. You wanted a clean break, I guess.
But you wanted a clean break from us.
Doesn't mean he accepts it.
I didn't want to be a part-time, pissed-off mother. Not fair to any of you. I left when Daniel was still very young, so he wouldn't remember me.
Did she hurt him worse? Not sure which one to choose here either. I mean, I guess he wasn't so lucky because he does remember her.
Yeah, I wasn't that lucky.
Oh, Sean, I know. Do you want to tell me how you felt then?
Betrayed, abandoned.
Or now?
Felt guilty. I don't know if he felt guilty. I mean, I can see feeling guilty. You have nothing to be guilty for, but he definitely didn't feel nothing. So, no, I don't want to tell you.
No, not really.
No problem. I hope I can make it up to you, Daniel, someday. I can start by getting his ass out of that church.
That would be a start.
Cult. Whatever.
Did you miss us?
So, did you ever actually miss us? Or Dad?
Of course, Sean. I do miss your father. He had such a big heart. He could brighten up a rainy day. That was like his superpower. But above all, I missed watching you grow up.
Speaking of superpowers...
See how you saw the world. I missed sharing these moments with you, Sean.
Does she have any powers? Because he might have gotten it from his mother. We used to do so much.
We used to do so much stuff. Like when you taught me to ride because Dad sucked. Or when we went camping near Vancouver. Just me and you.
You always loved night skies.
I did stargaze a lot when I was in California.
Trust me, the further south you go, the better it gets.
Whatever. You sound so... careless. It's like you can't even realize how much pain you've caused.
I do care. It's why I'm here. To help you and your brother. If I didn't step up to help him now, I couldn't live with myself.
You could live with yourself back then, though? I don't smoke. Don't ask anything.
No, man. Esteban hated when I smoked. He didn't want me to die an early death. Fuck. Life can be so cynical sometimes.
I remember he would smoke sometimes. Long ago.
We didn't fight much. But when we did, I would go out on the porch and light up so I could calm down. Esteban would come over and ask for a drag. Then we just look up at the sky and watch the stars. Or the planes. I do miss that.
I used to do the same thing with my best friend Lila. Smoking on the porch. Just letting time go.
That's when you know someone is good to you. When you can just sit together. Shut the hell up and watch the universe do its own thing.
She has a plan to get Daniel out of this place. Or if she's just winging it. Maybe she also has a power and she's gonna use that. Sure, she doesn't want people to see it. But maybe she'd take a chance for Daniel. That's if she has it. I wonder how he gets this power. Well, got this power. Am I supposed to back out of this? Is this is just going on and on. Yeah.
We should go back inside.
Okay.
I gotta change this dressing.
Okay. Let's go.
Knees are already going.
Sean, I know I can't change the past or what I did, but this is about helping your brother. You gotta trust me this one time.
Has she talked to Daniel? Has Daniel seen her? I know.
I know. It's still hard. But yes, we have to be a team to rescue Daniel.
Whatever, we can do it.
Whatever it takes.
Okay. How?
We need to get in touch with this Jacob. He obviously knows a lot more than us about the church.
Well, I called him when you were out. We can meet with him tomorrow.
Okay, good. I also got these, just in case.
What's that? Oh. CBs? Walkie talkies?
Okay. Better take care of the eye.
So, do you need any help with that?
Mm-mm. No.
No. I got this.
So, you feel like telling me the story here?
Not really.
I would have told her.
Gotcha.
At least some of it.
Here, try this on.
With that. Oh. She got an eye patch. He almost like yanked it out of her hand. I don't know if I put it in that dirty sink like that. Close the door.
How do I look?
Like a pirate.
Great.
Arr.
Thanks.
Big day tomorrow, so we should get some rest.
Yeah. I'm ready to get Daniel.
Meeting point. The next day. Yeah, I don't think there would be any way to save his eye. There's too many scenes that have to do with the eye that they would have to cut out in order to accommodate for him still having an eye, you know. If that makes any sense. I don't know how else to explain it.
Sure he's gonna show up?
Is it 4 p.m. yet?
He better. He promised.
Well, if he doesn't find us, we'll find him.
Hmm. One way or
the other. I can't believe how much crap you guys have been through. Makes me want to punch in the face each and every asshole that got in your way.
Yeah. Well, good thing we got to meet amazing people, too.
She wasn't there.
Life on the road is all about that. The sweet encounters.
Hope I can see them again someday.
The birds.
Oh, you will. So tell me about Daniel. What's he like?
He's special. Not just because of his power.
Well, he's definitely special.
Hope so. He's your brother, right?
Yes.
Heads up. Is that him?
No idea.
Yep. Wait here.
How do you know what kind of car he drives?
Sean!
He looks different.
What happened?
No facial hair? Yeah. Can you explain?
Jake, I'm not mad, but you better explain everything.
I didn't know where else to go. Listen, I saw Daniel come back to the camp that night. Like, he was in shock or something. Then I heard all these sirens and I got scared. I packed a few things, I took a blanket from your tent, and we left together.
That same blanket?
I also kept the cash you made on the farm.
Ah!
It's in my car.
You stole my cash.
Oh! So you took my brother and my money!
Better me than the cops, don't you think? You have no idea what he looked like when I found him that night, Sean. He was in bad shape, with a gunshot wound. And all by himself, I got shot in the shoulder?
Couldn't
just leave him there.
Something like that. What about the others?
What about the others? Hannah, Penny, what happened to them?
Cassidy? Well, Cassidy was there.
They ran over to Merrill's place when they found out Finn and Cass were gone. That was the last time I saw them. Then on our way out here, Daniel told me more about what happened that night. How scared he was. The blast. Daniel feels he's gotta redeem himself for what he did.
I need to get to him, Jacob. He's not guilty of anything. I should have protected him better.
I'm telling you to be careful with the Reverend Mother. She's waited her whole life for somebody like Daniel. The Reverend knows how to manipulate people. She's good at this. He wants to stay with her.
Yeah.
Daniel
got that.
Has faith in the Reverend now.
That's a problem. I'll say I'm afraid of her. Well, intimidated. You did nothing? I mean, true. Daniel didn't do anything wrong. He said his money's in the car, so I'm assuming he's going to give it back to him. It's over $1,000. I don't know where the $17 come from, unless that's some of it. I don't know where else he'd get $17 from. He's got to help. Him and Karen. So you did nothing?
Did you even try to stop her?
Sean, stop it! Why did you think I wrote to your mother?
I was gonna grab
her. Come on.
Grab him.
There's no way they're gonna let you take him away. Well,
too bad. We're not gonna ask for their permission.
Got that
you
right.
You must be Jacob. I'm Karen. Hi.
Okay. I don't know if you want to do this, but I have an idea. I think school must be over by now. But Lisbeth will stay at the church with Daniel for his special classes. That'll give us time to sneak into the compound before we get to them.
I'll
be on the lookout. Keep watch in case it all goes to shit. Sean, stay on the walkie.
Sounds like a plan.
One more thing. We have to get my sister, too. Sarah Lee.
Really, Jacob?
Oh.
Come on, man.
That's her.
She's with your parents.
I know. Please, listen, Sean.
They took her?
She's not safe here. She's sick. They believe in everything Lisbeth says.
Yeah.
And she says she'll cure Sarah with prayers.
Yep.
I know you understand.
And not medical help.
Right?
Damn, Jake.
We need his help too, Sean.
Yeah, we'll help get her.
Okay, Jake. I'm listening.
Lisbeth knows what's wrong with Sarah Lee. We need to find her medical record. I think it's in her home office.
Do you know
Then I'll go get Sarah Lee while you get Daniel. Okay?
Fine.
Okay. Sure.
I'm gonna trust you on this, Jacob. All good for you, Karen.
What if Daniel won't go with you?
He will.
It'll be a problem.
I know him.
Gotta persuade him. And he can stop us from taking him. With his power, so we have to persuade him. Either that or knock him over the head and, you know, just carry him away. What a mess. So she won't take Sarah Lee, like the, you know, the snack cakes. She won't take Sarah to get medical help. They just want to pray that'll fix everything. Nope, she needs medical help. That's why they were doctors.
Karen?
I'm in place. I can see the whole camp. Let me know if you need anything.
Now what is she gonna do?
Got it. Thanks.
We gotta be careful now. If anything happens, let me do the talking, okay?
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
Let's get this over with.
Okay. Lisbeth's house is right behind the church, so in and out.
Okay. And you sure Lisbeth will have those files on your sister?
Watch out, Sean. There are people right outside.
Oh, shit. How many?
Where?
Just three. A man with his kid on one side, and a woman alone on the other.
Got it. Thanks.
People aren't supposed to come and go around the church once the service is over. Better to avoid them if we can.
Let's go around this way then, right? That we're supposed to do? Can't run a rescue mission without these, right? Walkie-talkie. Jacket. Seems pretty useless in this heat, but I hear nights are rough around here. Yeah, it can get cold at night. Medical stuff. It's cool Karen hooked me up with some meds. Supposed to use saline solution too, though. I don't think that's included. Karen wants to talk. It's hard, but I'm trying to hear her out. Not sure if I'll ever understand what she's been through or what she's after. But I can try.
So, did you grow up out of here?
No. In another community back when Lisbeth came out here to start Haven Point, my folks followed her and brought me along.
Do we want
to
avoid people?
Hmm. Must have been hard on you.
Oh.
Come on.
Well, hello, young Hackerman. What are you doing here?
Is that the last name?
Oh, hi. We're just...
You know you're not supposed to wander around the church once the service is over, right?
Forgot something.
Right, I'm sorry, but we were just...
Say nothing.
My dad just forgot his, jacket in our reverend's home, so he asked me to go get it.
That is so Robert. And he's too proud to get it back himself.
You know the man.
Okay, well, just hurry up. We'll be closing the gates soon.
No worries. I'll just grab it and go.
I don't know who that is, but... Jacob told us not to say anything to let him do the talking, so I followed that instruction.
Ooh, sounds like she has a soft spot for your dad.
He does have some fans here. She's definitely one.
Good thing you dropped his name.
Then we should have some time to snoop around.
Should we snoop around or just go in the...
That's where I live.
Back there?
That big house over there.
That one or that one?
You live in a castle, dude.
No. There's actually four families in it.
What?
Jeez.
Seriously?
Yeah. It was the easiest thing to do when we built this place.
Man. That sucks.
Well... You get used to it.
No one's inside. Good.
You stand on over there. Oops.
Is this Daniel's room? Oh, damn.
Guess so.
So this is Daniel's not-so-secret garden. Great.
I wonder how that whole thing happened with him, with them finding out his powers. Did they find it out, like, accidentally? Was he not being careful? Or did he just come out and show them, look what I can do, kind of thing? It was this back door. I know we don't want to go in there. Nope, he won't go there. Alright, let's go in. I only see one door this place. He won't run. This is me holding down the run button. So this is how fast he goes. So is he in here? It doesn't look like there's anybody in here.
Can't believe Daniel really lives in this depressing house.
Oh, we did it. Now we have a little bit more time.
Do you have to find files?
Yes, we do. Nice work. So where are the files?
Right there, in her office. Oh, of course it's locked. Her open door speech is just another lie. We gotta find a way in.
Fuck. Think there's a key somewhere?
Maybe she's too cautious not to have a spare set around.
Maybe. We will look around.
Whoa.
Are you okay, Jake?
Yeah. Yeah, no. It's just so full of memories and stuff.
Damn. This is so artless.
Artless art.
Confide and convince? 15 steps to a good speech. Yeah, nice read for a saleswoman. The evenings in here must be so much fun. Lisbeth sure likes to be on pictures.
Guess so.
Must be a way to break it.
Or open it. Chores list?
Whoa. This place is worse than army camp.
I can't imagine Daniel enjoys doing these chores. Cleanliness is next to godliness. Daniel, household duties. Make bed every morning, clean dishes after every meal, vacuum hall and room weekly, take out trash Monday, wash hair every 2 days, help with Sunday laundry, count your blessings daily. Cereal.
Coaxing lesson one. Get Daniel his favorite cereal.
Yeah. Oh, paper.
The moat and the bean.
New morning family practice. John Robert, MD. Patient named Elizabeth Fisher. Antibiotics for yeast infection? Ew. She has a yeast infection. 250 milligrams twice daily. Atvol for stress, anxiety. 0.5 milligrams once daily as needed. Refills allowed. Nasty. Well, if we run into her, well, hope I can confront her about her yeast infection. You won't even clean yourself properly. I know that's not the way it works, but that's ammunition.
Might be enough to open that door.
I'll think about it. Scissors.
Daniel's haircut makes much more sense now.
Pills.
This is a lot of pills.
For her? Or him?
Especially for someone who doesn't believe in science.
Yeah, really. Why don't you just pray and make it better? Works for Sarah Lee, doesn't it? Not really, but... church organ.
Did she teach Daniel how to play this?
Maybe.
Sean, is everything all right in there?
Yes. We're trying to get into her office. She's locked it up, so it has to be there.
Fine. I'll let you know if I see anything unusual.
Okay.
Got it.
Religious icon.
Does she even believe in any of this?
Probably. In a twisted way. Anything in there?
I swear. Even her bet looks stern.
Yeah. Baron.
Yeah. That will definitely explain what's going on with Daniel.
Miracles. Where do they come from? What do they mean? You'll never know. That Daniel's drawing?
What a great fucking family portrait.
Newspapers?
She sure likes to gaze at her own success.
Oh. She's got a little scrapbook going here. Or a start of one. Former uprising church pastor founds Haven Point. Haven Point Church gains in popularity.
Is this Daniel's room?
Yeah.
Man. It's depressing.
Well, Lisbeth doesn't believe in material possessions, so...
Doesn't mean you need to decorate your house like a prison.
I'm sure the key wouldn't be in his room, but I want to see what's around. Oh, Finn's bracelet?
No matter what happened, I guess Finn was a real friend to Daniel.
Yeah.
The Book of Daniel.
What?
So much for Hot Dog Man.
Huh. Daniel 7? I, Daniel, was troubled in spirit, and the visions that passed through my mind disturbed me. I approached one of those standing there and asked him the meaning of all this. So he told me and gave me the interpretation of these things. The four great beasts are four kings that will rise from the earth, but the holy people of the Most High will receive the kingdom and will possess it forever. Yes, forever and ever. Is this from the Bible, or... And for all I know, there is a Book of Daniel. I never heard of it, necessarily, but... I'm not familiar with the Bible, so... What do I know?
They're so cute.
Anime eyes. Seems like something like Sarah would have drawn this. Yeah, well, she wrote her name. Nice boxes, huh?
This is quite the change from Power Bear and Friends.
Yeah. Papers.
What is this? Daniel Fisher? Oh no. No, that's total bullshit.
Ah!
And creepy.
She's saying he has her last name.